to the south is the Rue de la Fontaine au Roi, where the killing continues.
So the gunmen came from the Petit Cambodge this way, pulled up holes in that restaurant there, and shot up the laundrette. And then the car stopped. Two men got out, and they shot at that restaurant there. And you can see from the sawdust and the blood on the pavement, they killed people there too. Five dead on this street, eight severely wounded. Next, the Belle Equipe. Two men opened fire from a car, spraying bullets at the terrace of the cafe. People say the car with the gunmen came this way, and they're firing at both sides of the street. They shoot up this hairdresser's here. On this side of the street, they shoot up the bakery. Next to the bakery, there's a bar, the Belle Equipe. There's a big game on, France versus Germany. Lots of people outside having fun. At the end of it, 19 people like that. The last restaurant's attack is at Le Comptoir Voltaire. A suicide bomber blows himself up, leaving several people injured. Fear rules the streets of Paris. By 20 to 10 local time, two of the three teams of gunmen have killed 40 people. Now a third team walk through the front doors of the Bataclan Music Hall, where Michael and Sarah are dancing just by the stage.
I seen somebody with a gun firing indiscriminately into the crowd.
Some people like dropping.
We seen people falling as he was firing into them, and everybody surging to get out. But so many people were pushing and trying to get towards the small exit.
A gunman makes his way up to the balcony to shoot down into the crowd.
All we could hear was the gunfire, which was pretty steady, pretty intense gunfire. Occasionally, we could hear them reloading and then just emptying another clip into the crowd.
We dropped
to the ground.
And this is where we stayed. We stayed there like for over an hour.
I was kind of lying over one side of Sarah here, mm-hmm. and to one side here was another girl who I put my arm over, and then behind her there was dead bodies. Just behind her.
Like 20 centimeters away from us.
Yeah.
There was a
bomb at one point, but the big explosion and pieces of the plaster from the ceiling like showering down on us, you know.
Smell. I thought for 1 second
sulfur.
I'm gonna die, like, was he asphyxiated?
Yeah.
Amid the shooting, Michael and Sarah hear the killers praying in Arabic and shouting, Allahu Akbar, God is great. One place to blame in French on President Hollande.
Si on est ici, c'est à cause de François Hollande.
The reason we're here is because of François Hollande.
Yeah.
C'est des balles.
And we also,
what did that mean to you?
To me, I'm quite aware of what was happening in Syria and with ISIS.
Outside the Bataclan, a journalist from the Paris newspaper Le Monde films from the window of his home. Dan Orseni's pictures shock the world. Terrifying scenes of people trying to escape the bloodshed inside. This young man, injured in the leg, struggles to get away. And this woman, desperate to survive, clings to a window ledge. Inside, Michael fears he and Sarah will not survive.
I was close enough to give her a little kiss and to hold her, and I just said, I love you, you know, and if I don't make it out of here, I...